Hey everybody, welcome back to another Nature's Always Right episode with Stephen Coronet. Today we are inoculating my field with some very inexpensive microbes. I'm going to show you how I'm doing this on a little 4-acre field, but this is something that you can do just on your garden. I did all these Korean natural farming inputs and Jadam inputs on my market gardens back in San Diego and had tremendous results. One of my big goals with my YouTube channel and my farm going into the future is to document the use of these inputs that we can scale up to very large scale farms. And I'm hoping to be able to work with a local farm around here that does everything conventional, you know, tilling, corn, soy, GMO, glyphosate, you name it. I'd like to approach them and say, hey, let's spray out these microbes, this natural fertilizer, this natural pesticide that we can make that 10 times cheaper the cost than what you're currently buying, and it's gonna be way better for your soil. That's what I'm gonna be doing today, guys. So what do I have in here? Well, I'll tell you guys that a week ago, I did JMS. That's the cheapest and easiest microbes that you can put out onto your garden or farm. This 4 acres probably cost me $5 to inoculate it. Get the Jadam book by Mr. Young Song Cho. It's an excellent book that details all of his ultra low cost organic methods that I've talked about many times here on the channel. You can see an interview video I did with him in Korea and in America if you want to learn more directly from him, or go watch his YouTube channel. But today we're actually going to be using his father's techniques, Master Cho, Hun Kyu Cho. This is liquid IMO using Master Cho's method, which is no electricity, no aeration. So it's the same thing as making JMS, where you're putting your inoculant, your IMO 3 or 4, in a bag, just like this. And I let it steep for about 24 hours, and then we're gonna inoculate right away. I did combine this with Chris Trump's technique. So Chris Trump aerates all of his, because microbes and fungi will grow out, especially the ones we want in our top layers of our soil. They're gonna be more aerobic. As we go down in the soil profile, it gets more and more anaerobic. So we do need a combination of both. And we do know that many microbes and fungi are facultative, which means they will switch between anaerobic and aerobic environments. So this is really, you're cultivating your microbes according to nature and the ambient temperature. So these microbes that I'm gonna be putting out in this field will persist very well. So what is in this? Like I told you, I combine it with Chris Trump's. So he does humic acid to help feed fungal life. So this is a ratio of 1 to 250 humic acid, 1 to 30 seawater, and 50 gallons of water, 10 handfuls of the inoculant, which I have IMO3. I'm currently making IMO4 and another IMO3 batch right now. So I'm putting out minerals in the form of sea salt. I'm putting out microbes that I've collected from the woods. And in this collection, I've got 6 different IMO2 collections I collected from different seasons. And then I grew them out into IMO3, you know, multiplying the fungal and microbial diversity, growing these persistent microbes out many thousand generations to get them stronger. And then we put them out into our farm or garden or our pasture to make that more resilient, to grow better grass, to grow better vegetables. So that's the power of this, you guys. This is so inexpensive. Is there a high learning curve to this? Yes, there is that. But if you're a couple years in the gardening, these are things you should be playing with and understanding so that you can make all of your own inputs yourself. And the whole reason that the Cho family created these agriculture technologies, or adapted them from other natural farmers around the world, to give back the power to the farmer so that they can be in complete control, not be subservient and debt slaves to these big ag companies. This is already a pre-diluted amount set up, so I'm just going to be dumping it into my sprayer. So let's take a look at what I've got here to spray. So this Kubota side-by-side, the Chapman sprayer, I'm borrowing from my friend Kyle Bell of Forest Fed Farm. So thank you, Kyle. So now, what we're gonna do, this is a 25-gallon sprayer, so this is one limitation, right? You know, if I wanna scale this up to do 100 acres, I'm gonna need a way bigger tank. I'm gonna need a way bigger tank to brew all this stuff. So these are all things I'm playing with and trying to learn. It's got a little pump on here that pressurizes the tank. It comes out through here, and then out through these 5 nozzles. Now these nozzles do spray a wide, really nice spray, but I did notice that it takes quite a while for it to all empty out of the tank. So what I did last time is I ended up taking off the nozzles so it would dump the water more quickly. And I did JMS the first time. You have to dilute that 10 times, and I made 100 gallons, so that would be 1,000 gallons, and that's way too many trips to do out here. So what I did is, to get around that, is I waited till we had a huge rain, and I timed my JMS with that, so the rain would dilute the microbes, and I wouldn't have to spend all this time driving or, you know, using my electricity to pump my well. So think about that timing if you can. Then the other thing that I learned from doing this the first time is I'm using a 5-gallon bucket to transfer my liquid from here to here. That's pretty inefficient, right, guys? So I need to buy myself a little battery-powered pump that's gonna pump between these. But then if you start talking about 1,000 gallons, then you need a more powerful pump, maybe a gas-powered pump. So it's 4 p.m. now. I'm gonna put down the liquid IMO, and then in about 3 to 4 hours, I will then put out the seed treatment solution, which is a bunch of Korean natural farming inputs combined together. And that's gonna be watered out. That's microbes, it's food, it's minerals. It's a bunch of different things. It's like a tonic for soil and plants that will help these microbes, and I'm putting them out right now, thrive and grow even better than they would without it. There are other techniques with the seed treatment solution, the soil treatment solution, where, you know, they'll put out charcoal in the whole field, then they put out the soil treatment solution, then a week later they put out the liquid IMO. So there's different ways that people do this. And you just kind of think about conceptually, what are you trying to achieve by putting this out in your field? And also there's a convenience factor too. I don't have the charcoal. Unfortunately, I don't have any rain in the forecast that will help water it in, but the ground is still very wet from the previous rains. So what I'm hoping is that because of that, then that the microbes will be able to infiltrate down deeper versus if it was dry, they'd just be soaked up in the first couple inches, which is another thing to think about. If maybe you're applying a certain set of microbes that you only want to stay in the top couple inches, maybe you want to send microbes super deep, like with JMS, there's more anaerobes. So, and JMS is very good at help loosening soil, making it softer, especially deeper down. So play with all those elements of nature and rain and the temperatures and all this. Before I tell you a little bit more about the results, I want to let you know I am doing a weekly email newsletter now where I put out unique content just for the email subscribers. Last week I did a special 20-minute homestead tour just for the email subscribers. So be sure that you're on there so you don't miss out on cool content like that. And if you'd like to support my work, you have lots of great options down below. Some even have discount codes to get you the best gardening and farming products on the market. I'm back about a week later after doing a total of 300 gallons. I did Jadon microbial solution, waited about a week, and then I did the liquid IMO and the soil treatment solution. If you want to learn how to do these things, I recommend getting the Jadon book, of course, that is excellent. And if you want some of the Korean natural farming books, those are more hard to come by. Some of them are out of print. And I'll put a website down below where you can still get them and his basic manual. Get the basic manual. That's something that everybody should have. It has all the recipes and all the instructions and all that good stuff. So one of my big takeaways from this is I need a bigger tank to put out the sprays. That's the biggest thing that I need to figure out next. I have some IBC totes up there. That could possibly work well. I also don't have access to that Kubota. My friend lives 30 minutes from me. I have to get a trailer to bring it down here. So, you know, if I'm doing that once a year, that's not a big deal. But if I want to do this more often, then I need to figure out some of the solution where maybe I'm towing an IBC tote on my trailer that has a PVC pipe attached to it and it's just dripping by gravity the soil drench out, something like that. So those are other little things I'll be working on, because we need solutions that don't cost money too, right, guys? I mean, as you know, prices for everything are going to continue to go up as the economic downturn increases. So and that's, you know, one of the big reasons that Jadon was even created was for people that do not have access to material or money. And that's why there's no electricity used. That's why the most cheapest materials are used, but to the most effective way possible. The other thing I'm doing for this field is I have taken soil tests. I did 3 soil tests on 3 different locations on the field. I spent over $180 to be able to do it. So I'm spending the money that I make from my channel, my Patreon, all these things, I'm putting it back into doing these special projects or building things that cost me more money so I can display that for you guys so that you can either learn from it or maybe you want to do it yourself or it'll save you time or money. So that's what I'm really passionate about in helping you guys. The whole point of showing the soil test really is to show and to show change over time and the soil improving over time with these techniques that I'm using, which are only natural, using my animals and then just natural farming techniques. So I'm really excited to show the change. It's got a long way to go to get to where I want it. The grass is not very good. The species in here are not very diverse. There's a lot of crappier stuff in there that sheep and cows, ruminants, just aren't as excited about. So going through this process of rotational grazing is going to improve that. Adding the microbes is going to, and the nutrients and all those things is going to improve that, change the soil, change the actual seeds that are able to sprout in this soil and survive.